Example of fugacity calculations. We're going to calculate first the fugacity of a pure gas at 30 bar and 500 Kelvin. And then we're going to assume that this happens to be the saturation pressure at 500 Kelvin. And we want to calculate the fugacity of a liquid in equilibrium with that gas. And then we want to increase the pressure on the liquid to 60 bar and calculate its fugacity. So we're given the volume of the liquid, and we're assuming that's constant over this pressure range. And we're assuming, or we're using, a compressibility factor that's a simplified form, basically to make the calculations easy, demonstrate what we're trying to show. So what we're going to do is use relation between the fugacity coefficient, which is the log of the fugacity over pressure, and it relates to the compressibility factor at constant temperature by this simple relation. And just a reminder of where this relation came from: the change in Gibbs free energy at constant temperature is VdP, and then the way we've defined fugacity, this is RT d log of fugacity. So I'm going to work with this relation, the log of the fugacity over pressure, integral from 0 to 30 bar. Z minus 1, we can see up here, Z minus 1 is just minus 0.01 pressure. So minus 0.01 pressure divided by pressure. And so we're just integrating minus 0.01, which is minus 0.01 times 30 minus 0, which just is equal to minus 0.30. If we take the exponent of both sides, fugacity over pressure is just e to the minus 0.30. Remember, we're evaluating this fugacity at 30, so this is really 30 times this exponential. And if we do that calculation, fugacity at 30 bar is 22.2 bar. Okay, that's part A. Now, part B says the liquid's in equilibrium. So this is the fugacity of the vapor. Fugacity of liquid is the identical value because they're in equilibrium. The fugacities are the same. And now for part C, we want the fugacity of the liquid at 60 bar. So what I've written down here is the pointing correction that relates to fugacity of a liquid at some pressure, the fugacity at saturation pressure, which is, of course, what we have already. This is the volume of liquid, molar volume, pressure difference over RT. So the fugacity at 60 bar is going to be 22.2, and then the exponent, and I'll substitute the numbers in. So now I can calculate the fugacity at 60 bar. The units cancel here, 25, 30, 83.14, and 500. While the determined exponent is quite small, so that the correction is insignificant at this pressure, so the fugacity at 60 bar pressure. So it takes a large increase in pressure to create a significant increase in fugacity for liquid.